Hi, you guys. It is the life of Amaya Lasanta. It's the life of Amaya. It's the life of Amaya. So, today is basically going to be a vlog of like how I am doing better. You know what I'm trying to say? So this is pretty much my update. And you guys, I have a surprise. So I was thinking, I'm always thinking, you guys, straight up, I am always thinking. So this is big to me. And I'm gonna do it, you know what I'm trying to say? I don't care how crazy it sounds or anything. It's gonna be a secret for you guys. I know exactly what it's gonna be, but moving forward, I feel as though, like, I don't know if you guys are gonna see in the last videos how I just, like, you know, there's nothing really happening in this current moment. You know what I'm trying to say? In this current moment, I am in college. I don't have any setbacks, you know what I'm trying to say? So why is it that I always go backwards from my past, you know, from my traumatic past? And it's like, moving forward, no matter if I am out of town or not, the name Amaya Lasanta is traumatic to me. It is. And like, you know, I'm gonna tell you guys the real drift of it, you know what I'm trying to say? And the reason why I say it's traumatic to me, and like, you know, I'm not really in a vulnerable state, I'm actually feeling good, but I say traumatic because, like, when I think about Amaya Lasanta, I think about all the sacrifices that I had to get here. You know what I'm trying to say? All the sacrifices that I had to get here. And that's who makes you you. But the thing is so fucking traumatic that, like, moving forward, I could be, you know what I'm trying to say, I'm meeting new connections and everything. But it's like when I meet somebody new, I'm introducing myself as Amaya. Like, hi, my name's Amaya. But that name holds a lot of traumatic event to me. So, like, and, like, it's just, like, yeah, like, I just think about all the shit that I have been through. And, like, for instance, like, two traumatic things that I have been through, right, is, first of all, in some aspects, I had to cross a lot of people to get to where I'm at. Not like in a bad way, but I had to, like, for instance, like, my mom was, you know, not in her best position, you know what I mean, to keep me. So in some aspects, I had to cross her, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, in all the relationships that I was in to make me think the way I am, you know what I'm trying to say? Those are traumatic events. Like, I was molested from 6 to 14 years old, you know what I'm trying to say? So it's things like that that just, like, make me cry out of nowhere. Like, literally, there would be nothing wrong with me and I'd just cry out of nowhere. And as far as family, like, I love my family dearly, but I don't think that they know that I'm doing them a favor. Like, I'm trying to put our name or build our name into something to change the generation curse. Like, I'm not doing this for myself. You know what I'm trying to say? So, it's just like... So then, like, you know, me, because I'm moving forward, I come off as bougie. So it's like, I don't even have my family with me. You know what I'm trying to say? And then my close friends, you know, at the end of the day, how I look at it is, like, if I don't know your intentions, like, I'd rather cut you off and risk that than risk having you come up with me and I don't know your intentions. You know what I'm trying to say? My friends are my team. You know what I mean? Those are the people that's closest that I'm supposed to trust. So I'm very weary on who comes now to my circle. You know what I'm trying to say? I'm not just speaking on, like, oh, even if I, you know, I'm trying to say, what is it? Even if I don't come up or if I do, I'm speaking on all levels of me now, for real. So, like, moving forward, like, I just want to change my name. I'm in the process of changing my name. Because, like, I don't know, like, I just feel like that would be better. Like, I will feel, I'm not trying to, like, all those certifications say Amaya Lasanta. I'm not going to get rid of those because it says my name, because at the end of the day, that was a part of me. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, that was a part of me. But at the end of the day, I don't want to hold on to that. I got my spa bed. I don't want to hold on to that baggage anymore, you know? Like, I just want a new start, you know, because a lot of people, even when I meet new people, they meet this current Maya now, but in my head, because all the traumatic shit I went through, you know, and even being in the court system, like, You know what I'm trying to say? I even have, like, that name attached to that. Like, I don't even want to be a part of that shit. So, like, I'm not forgetting who I am. I'm not. I know that I went through placement for a reason. I know that I went through all this stuff. I know that it was this hard to graduate high school. I know it was this hard to get back into college. But at the end of the day, it's done. You feel me? From here, it's just positive people. It's just a positive mindset. So I don't want to keep holding on to that anymore. So yeah, so that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to change my name. It's going to take a while, but I really want to change my name. I already have a name in mind. I don't want to change my last name. I just want to change my first name. Period. And that's what I'm going to do. People are like, oh my God, you're so crazy. Fuck you. It's for a reason, like, period. And then from here, like, I don't even attach myself to the Amaya, you feel me? I look at myself for who I am. You feel what I'm trying to say? And that's a fact. That is a fact. All right, so, anyways, after my rant on changing my name and blah, 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 but I am doing better, you guys. Everything is more coming along in school. When I first did school, when I first did school and just, like, studying and stuff like that, it was really hard. It was very depressing. It was very lonely. But honestly, I've been at the school gym a lot, and I've been talking to a lot of, like, grad students and everything, and they tell me it's just part of the process, so you just have to love it. So I am. So for instance, I'm going to be in this area for about, what time is it? It is 12:36. I'm going to be here for about, I'm gonna study for 3 hours, take my test, so that's gonna be probably 2 hours to take the test. So it's 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So from 12 to 7 o'clock, I promise you, from 12 to 7 o'clock, I'm going to study my notes because I really want to get 100%. I didn't put in all this work, and I will prove to you guys that I am prepared. I want to show this part because I feel like this is the hardest part. Like, you know what I'm trying to say? I feel like the hardest part sometimes is just, like, in my life is just, like, I get sad, like, right about now. I'm just like, damn, like, you know, better to achieve. Because, like, this is the part that, like, makes me sad. Is, like, you know, like, I don't know. I don't know if it's, like, I'm so destined to be where I'm at or where I'm going, that, like, things get happen that are, like, unexpectedly, you know? So, first step of my name change. She's like, what am I supposed to say? Like, either said you could take 2 or you could take 5, but then they said because of my GPA, I'm not qualified to come back. And I'm like, okay, like, I don't know what to do. Because, and I wouldn't even regret this year, because I needed the process. Like, and it just sucks, because now I understand that, like, you telling your story and stuff like that to college, it really doesn't matter, you know? Like, it doesn't matter. Like, I can't sit here and say anymore and use that as an excuse. Well, like, my mom never really, I was never in school, I was never this. Like, the system is designed for you to fail. You know what I'm trying to say? So I need to stop, get that out of my head, and just, like, you know.
Where are we going?
To the main campus.
This is
the
main campus.
Like, to the, you know.
The front?
Yeah, to the front.
Is there a place to park there?
Together.
Don't get too excited. All right.
I'm just looking for, let me see here. So worst case scenario, let's say the appeal is denied.
Mm-hmm.
And
it really has been a pleasure to watch you grow. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like you and I, like we've gone rounds for rounds before. Like it's not, that's no surprise. Like our relationship has definitely been like ups and downs, but at the end, like I'm glad that we stuck together.
Yeah, that is true.
Because I have so much respect for you.
Aww.
Knowing where you came from. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, and don't let anybody ever take that away from you. Like, no.
You've not got a 0.24 in college. Woo woo. If I ever become.
Yeah, do you guys still have the snacks?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm a good.
Okay, I got some snacks. If you want tea, we can do tea too, but we're not letting you sell. We have to secure it. So, let me know.
Okay. So, this is food, you guys. Everything is so. Like, I look a mess. I'm trying not to show my face as much today because it is.
God had a name, what would it be? Would you call it to his face? If you were faced with him and all his glory, what would you ask?
You do not have the right to change the right to a change of name. The court can deny. Petition the court. Yeah.
One question. Yeah. Yes. I know.
God. We need to be way more helpful than just some random stuff we found on the internet. Wish I would have found this one first.
People knowing what I'm doing currently. So my caseworker, shout out to my caseworker, she helped me to think of something because I was like, yo, I really want to do YouTube. YouTube really makes me happy. But the reason why I can't do YouTube is because I don't want everybody knowing my every move. When I'm in a bigger city and I like get my career that I want, then I can like move like every YouTube. But right now it's all about using your head and how you can do things unique, you feel me? So what I'm gonna do is 3 months, right? I'm gonna record for 3 months, so this footage is already gonna be done, so you guys are gonna be 3 months behind my life. So right now I'm like, what the fuck do you mean? Like, what you mean I might not be going here? So I really had to like really hurry up and adapt. And like, one of the things about being successful, the most successful person adapts quick to their surroundings. Like, if you gonna be stubborn, like for instance, we had the COVID, you know, if you was gonna like still be in your ways, you was gonna get left behind. Same shit with life, you know. So if I don't adapt to the college mentality, and in some aspects I just felt like my situation was so unique, like I was gonna be able to like, oh, you're different, like, you know, like if I was late, I was walking an hour to and from work 4 hours a day just to go to work, my nigga. So I'm like I just felt like I would have sympathy, but for real, the system is not designed for me to win. So I had to realize that too. Like, you're gonna have to play by their rules to win. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm good now. I'm straight. I'm doing well in college. I'm more full of trying to get back into college. So I have all my stuff, you know. You know, I gotta be honest. So, a bitch got hit by a car, so that's her bill. You know, I'm gonna show you guys the information. And then we got my, basically, like, diagnosed with bipolar and stuff like that. That was the reason why, like, you know, it is what it is. So, like, I realized that mental health is more important. Like, I'm realizing as I get older, like, you know, I always bypassed it. But, you know, I feel like, because my manic, I can do shit like this. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, because I'm manic, it's easy for me to put my reality, my whatever. guys, today I got a box with my spa's name on it. Look. A Maya luxury spa. If it wasn't for YouTube, you guys, I would be experiencing this by myself. So that's why I love YouTube so much. So basically, I started a business called Amaya, Lasanta Luxury Spa. So I started last year, 2020. It was official as fuck. I was doing eyelash extensions and facials. So let's take it back to 2018. I love makeup and I couldn't afford to get my eyelashes done. So I said, boom, let's just do my eyelash extensions. At first I started with like these eyelash extensions that you get at the store, which comes already like pre like glued or whatever. I did those, they look like shit, right? So me just thinking, I'm like, yo, if I can do this on myself, I can do it on other people. So I did it on other people, right? I was charging people $15. My foster mom left at the time, and that's all I had because I quit my job because OCY told me, like, we'll pay, and they lied. They only gave me $200 a month. You can't do shit with that. So I'm like, what the fuck? So I had to do that to eat. So that $15 I would get from people, I was actually getting food. So I did that, and I wasn't that great. And I moved into my old house, and I'm like, what the fuck? I don't have a room no more. I just have items. So I took 4 months to make the place all nice, right? Lesson number one that I did, right? I had the spa, but I fucking sucked. I sucked at eyelash extension. So I'm like, fuck, another thing that I have to deal with. For the past, what was it? 4 months it took me to get it done. After the 4 months, it took me 4 months to get certified in facials, eyelash extensions. And the girl that does eyelash extensions live in LA. And she's fucking good. She does all celebrity eyelash extensions. So me, I paid her $2,000 to work with her. More money. Bitch, I don't have that much. I was making $8 at the time. Fuck. So I was sacrificing eating, right? Right? OCY told me everything was going good. I was making $1,000 in a week. Compiche? Right? I was making $1,000 in a week. They told me you gotta go. I'm like, what the fuck? I got a whole business. School is starting in 3 weeks. So guess what I had to do? Right? Guess what I had to do? I was homeless. Luckily, I had my job. You feel me? So then I took the time. I was gonna forget about my spa. I really was. I wasn't gonna focus on it. I was living with a roommate. I had a choice to make. You either be a college student and live comfortable as fuck and got all this money, and that's that. Shit didn't go as planned, right? She left and I'm like, I got this empty ass room. I'm paying $1,000 a month to live in this neighborhood. So I'm like, fuck it. I'm gonna just turn this into a spa and I'm gonna do what I'm gonna do. But it costs more because I had to get certified in microblading, which was $3,000. Then I had some other stuff that I had to get certified, but it's exciting because I got this stuff. Feel me? I can't tell you guys my lick, you feel me? But I'm excited. But that's a little bit, but I do got that in store. It's just hard because it's like I got so much going on for myself, but how can I manage this, you know? Well, my ass is getting fat, you guys. I'm gaining my weight back, but yeah, I'm excited though. We just gonna see how this goes. So either way, if I don't go to college and I guess I don't get accepted, I got a whole business. It's just, I really want to go to LA. That's my dream. I want to live in LA. I fucking want to live in LA or Texas. I'm going to get the fuck out of here one way or another. I'm telling you. But I'm not stupid. So let me tell you guys something. So I was in my art class, right? And I'm going to tell you guys, I'm so good at poetry. And it's how I know I'm not retarded. It's just, it's my situation that stops me. Okay, listen. So this is, okay, so the assignment in school was pretty much to do, sorry, I'm thinking about two things at once. I'm thinking about, like, I got a new computer for YouTube, which is $1,600, and I invested it. And this brings me happiness, you know, because I'm not going to have time to socialize, you know, this whole process. I got 6 years, so if I do what I have to do, I'm not going to have time to socialize, no relationships. And that shit gets depressing. But in some way, YouTube brings me alive. You know what I'm trying to say? Because I don't feel alone no more. I feel as though I have a purpose, you know? So I'm excited about this process of like starting YouTube again and just showing you guys the process. Back to what I was trying to tell you guys with my assignment for art appreciation.
We had to combine two images together and then tell a story. But I'm gonna tell you guys how good I am and so creative I am, right? All right, so this is the image right here. I don't know if you guys can see it, but look deep into this, right? Look deep into it. Y'all see it? All right, and I'm gonna read you what I said based on this. So it's basically like, I know I'm extra, but like, just read this. So imagine the image I showed you, and this is exactly what I was going through. I was so depressed yesterday. I was crying my eyes off because I was like, oh my God, I don't know what to do, da 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 da. So it says, my body is in blue poison. The pink represents the hope I still hold on to. Will they one day mix and I shall get sick? Is it a way the outside knowledge I observe can make me fix? Or will I shall die? I'm drowning, I can feel. My brain may can heal by the pink that still reveals. Save me, I say for real. Or is there no such a thing? I guess it's up to me, I see. I turn on the light within this bulb, and yes, I am healed while I sob. Woo! Boom. Damn, that is deep. So it's pretty much saying, let me break it down to you guys, just in case you guys are not into like poetry. So it says, my body is in blue poison. You see how this girl is sinking and she's in blue poison? So she's like dying, you know? But if you think about it, in my situation that I was in, is like the fact that I don't really have no education, you know, I'm in the system, you know, I'm trying to say I come back from the background I have, is basically poison within me. You feel me? The pink represents the hope that I still hold on to. So this right here is my drive, my ambition that still makes me alive, because really I should be a crackhead right now because all this shit that I've been through, but I'm not. And then it says, will they one day mix and I shall get sick? So will this pink die off? Will this pink die off? Like, will this pink, the little bit of hope, turn into blue because I let it get ahead of me? You feel me? And then it says, one day mix or will I get sick? Is it a way the outside knowledge I observe can make me fix? Is it a way? Because this represents the knowledge, right? Think of it as in my life, okay? As how much people helped me. You saw my caseworker help me. The teachers are pushing to help me. Is it a way that it can make me fixed? Or will I shall die? Or is it because my product of my environment is so sick that I shall die? You feel me? I'm drowning, I can see. I can see. I'm aware that this situation gets a hold of me. You feel me? My brain can heal by the pink it still reveals. Meaning there's still hope. There's still hope. But is it enough to keep me alive? Save me, I say for real. Or is there no such a thing? So I'm asking people to save me. I'm asking, hey, if I get out of the environment, can you save me? Is there such a thing? I guess it's up to me, I see. It's up to me. It's up to me to rise above. You feel me? I turn on the light within the bulb. You know, I'm in knowledge, you feel me? So I'm turning on the light. And yes, I will heal as I sob. So I'm saying I will rise above, but it still doesn't take away from all the pain that I have withstood within my body. Boom! Boom, 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 boom. All right. So I know it's gonna get 10 minutes. I have a problem when I record. So basically, this is going to be the first video. So what I'm pretty much going to do is, because I realized too, I don't like everybody knowing my every move. I do not like it. So what I'm going to do is basically, I'm going to just be recording, and then you guys are going to be behind 3 months. So nobody's going to know what I'm doing, because it's like you're going to be three months behind. But subscribe to my channel. There's going to be more videos of me through this process. At the end of the day, school is my most priority. School is my main focus. So I'm gonna try to post every week. If I don't, then that's that. You feel me? I'm not a robot. I wish I was, but I'm not, as much as I try to be. So leave a comment in below, subscribe to my channel, and I'll keep you guys updated if I get into school. If I don't, hopefully I do. I don't know what to do if I don't. All right.
fucking bitch. You talking all that shit like you be really in the mix. Nigga, use a cold snitch, so don't be trying me shit. And if you wanna talk this shit, then you would die, little bitch. Because I'm a gang nigga.
Boy! My life, but like the thing about it was different is like people, I'm not recording like I was doing, you know how I was doing like videos and like I would post it as soon as it would happen. So like, you know how like the Kim Kardashians, they got a show, they don't ever post the show of like what they're doing, they post a season behind. So like they're doing stuff, which is smart as fucking like marketing.
Yeah, that's how they do it. Yeah, like
so then people are always like engaged, you feel what I'm trying to say? Like, and I realized that because, like, a lot of people, like, they follow my lead. They follow.
It makes you upload. It makes you be more, it makes you more, it makes you more be there. Like, basically, the people know that you're not going nowhere. And they don't got to wait for your videos.
Right, right. Oh, shit.
Because that's what really people lose the followers. Because after just a week, bro, they're going to move on to something. They probably move on to something that same day, you know what I'm saying? Like, they probably just click away. So, like, even if they're watching YouTube and then you don't even post and say, like, hey, I'm about to post this, they're not going to, because they're like, oh, I don't know if it's ready yet, you know? That's right. Why I got to post shit on my Facebook. And, like, that's why I'm like, oh, an interview's coming soon. So when people know to stay tuned, to, so when the interview comes, it just don't come out of nowhere and be like, yo.
As I was saying, one quality that I have that is really good is, like, the time of stress. When it comes to stress, I can manage stress. Like, the impossible, I would keep my composure. Like, people are like, do you not know that you're, like, in debt or you got this going on or this? I'm like, no problem. Like, I think about it logically. Like, for instance, like, where's my planner? I think... And I already have these uploaded, you know what I'm trying to say, and I do it every week. That means that my life is, I'm videotaping the week of, do you know what I'm trying to say? So therefore, to get, you're just going to be a year behind, basically, which is kind of really, really good, honestly, because, like, nobody's going to know my moves at all. Like, it's going to be, like, impossible, but at the end of the day, damn. I wanted you guys to, like, be 3 months behind. Not no fucking year. So, y'all gonna be watching this. I'm gonna, like, be living life. And y'all gonna be thinking I'm still struggling and shit. I'm gonna be having my whole business ran. And y'all gonna be thinking I'm just started where I'm struggling to get in college. Oh, speaking of that, that was the reason why I was doing this video.
Inside of my head, I made it on my own. They said I'd be in jail. guys. I am so tired, you guys. I am still doing this paper. It is 2:42. I've been here since I ate at, like, I can't even remember what time it was. Like, probably like 8, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. I've been here for 6 hours. Oh my god. Oh my god, I've been researching. So basically, I have an assignment about mesothelioma. Sorry guys, I have like an accent, so some of the words that I say is like, you know, I can't control it. But it's basically like a cancer type, and like, basically this
is it. I had to like double space it, and then it's still going. And then this part right here, like, this is what I mean by when I say like I have to fix all this shit, because like I kind of like, yeah, it's just so much information, and like I don't know all of it, so I have to like fix it, like, you know what I mean, like, into my own words. And then there'll be like wording that's like different print and shit like that, so I have to like format it, put it to the way it's supposed to. Like this right here, Johnson & Johnson didn't tell the FBI, so I had to go find proof, and I had to go look so deep that I had to, oh my god, it was just a mess. So now I'm actually like putting it together, and then after this I just have to do, obviously, space that out, so that's gonna be about like 13 pages. And then I just have to do the that part, and then I'm done. Hi you guys. So I'm gonna film because I was so excited because I did my microblading. I had posted a video and I saw, like, you know, my flaws in my microblading or whatever, but like, I'm very, like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I have a lot of influence without, like, even though I'm so private, you guys, I do have, like, a lot of, like, influence. I have a lot of people watching me, even when I'm not doing YouTube, you feel me? So, it's just, like, you know, every time I do something, no matter how I move, like, for instance, me changing my name, I inspire people. And I'm, like, that, and people are getting the wrong dialogue, like, oh, yeah, you're right, because of, like, my parent named me, so I don't have enough power. I'm like, no, that's not what I was trying to do. That's not what I was trying to do. But I just, like, you know, I wanted to record this process because I want to give you guys the raw footage. You know what I'm trying to say? I think I made the mistake on my other, like, when I had my YouTube, before I started doing YouTube again, of just not being honest and not showing you guys the dark side and the light side. You know, when I was looking at my YouTube videos, I would always, like, look and watch them, and I'm like, oh my god, you seem so happy. And then, like, I would be like, why did I block out, like, the hard times that made Amaya? You know, why did I block out that time? But I just wanted to record because I was like, I don't have anybody to call, you feel me? I don't have anybody to call. So I just got on the phone with my aunt, and she just, I meant it to her. I just got on the phone with her, and I just vented, like, about, like, what I was going through with, like, my name change and, like, you know, everything that I'm going through with school and, like, how hard I'm working and, you know, just working, like, the hours that I am, and just, like, you know, like, I'm aware that, like, you know, I gotta keep on pushing and stuff like that. But I think it just hit me when I did my microblading, and, like, I didn't do as well as I wanted to. And, like, now I have people on the internet, like, you know, that's talking shit or whatnot. It's like, I put so much money into it. I put $2,500 when I could have bought a car. You know what I'm trying to say? So it's just like, you know, I just got to keep on going. And the reason why I wanted to talk to my saints was because it was just, I was just going through a lot, you know, and I just want to, I was just going through a lot because I think I'm just looking at the bigger picture. Because when I was on the phone with my aunt, she was pretty much telling me, like, damn, like, and it made me cry because she was like, when I think of about Amaya, like, I think about all these wonderful things and, like, how you overcame this and you did this, and now that you're changing your name, it's, like, nothing. And I was like, I feel the same way, you know what I'm trying to say? I really do feel the same way, you know? Because, but that's the reason why I'm changing it, is because I feel the same way. Like, you know, I don't feel as though there's nothing besides, like, darkness attached to it. I keep addressing this, and it's like, you know, it's just my biggest fear, and I know that's going to push me to do farther in life, because my biggest fear is to not change my name and not to do anything with it. So I know that it's going to push me far in life, but it's just a weird time right now. It's just a really real weird time, you know, because I did lose everybody that I once loved, and the connections is not there, like, you know. So it's just about pushing to the next chapter, you know, because change is hard. It's like, damn. But I think I just wanted to show you guys this part of, like, how sometimes a person, you know, doesn't have ups and downs. We go through a lot of things, so I just want to show you guys this part of me. But I know I'm strong. I know I'm gonna get through it. Like, just gotta keep on pushing. You know, like, I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna show y'all what I done. It's alright. I don't know. I'm very, like, I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. Like, I'm very, like, I shouldn't feel that way. But, like, I think I'm going through all this stuff and everything because, like, I'm very suicidal. Like, I think that's what my problem is. Like, I'm very suicidal at the moment. And, like, you can't really tell anybody that, like, I'm suicidal. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, hopefully I don't act upon it, or I'm not going to act upon it. You know, it's just, like, I feel that feeling of, like, I don't know. It's just a feeling. But, like, I went through all these mountains in my life. So, it's, like, every time I felt that way, I'm, like, I'm glad I lived. You know, I'm glad I didn't give up. So, it's, like, I'm not going to give up because I know that feeling. Like, damn, if even me looking at my life when I was 14 years old, looking at my life now, would I have got this far? Would I be in my own house? Would I have my own business? Even though it's not going as I wanted it to, would I have went that far? You know? So, I just hope school does well. I just got to talk to my professor. So, at work, I'm going to work on my stuff. It's just, it's been a really hard week. So, I really haven't done no schoolwork. None. Not at all. And, like, my clients and stuff kept canceling. And I, y'all see it. Like, you know, I was just very tired this week. But, yeah, so hopefully this week lightens up a little bit, you guys, where I have some good news to show y'all.
I know your body wanna work it in some time. Try to bring in more deposits. Gotta play for things. I told myself I gotta stop it. Get so much in me, but I need me to make a profit. Know your body wanna work it in some diamonds. She said I don't come with emotion, but I'm trying. Look in the mirror, do you like?
I can't even talk right now, like, I'm mad because, so I asked my job if it was 6 o'clock, and, like, this is where it's hard, where it's, like, I can't do everything, you know what I mean? And it's, like, and this is the part, too, where it's, like, people don't see this side, you know what I'm trying to say? They see me making moves, but you don't see what it takes to be in my shoes, you know what I mean? Like, I am so, like, sad because, like, I'm like, okay, I gotta study. You know what I mean? Mind you, motherfuckers don't know that I be walking an hour just to get to work. Motherfuckers don't care. And that's why I don't kiss and tell. You know what I mean? But, like, he was just like, I gotta shift. Like, we need to be taken more serious and this, and that, third. Nigga, do you know what I went through just to get that class? Like, what the fuck? So it's like, so what you want me to do? Put this job before my education and just say fuck it for a job? So now I just walked 45 minutes and then my boss is going to tell me, like, sorry, we don't need you. So I got to walk 45 minutes back. Like, you know, like, my heart's so cold. Like, I can't even cry. You feel me? Like, I promise you, I haven't cried in so long. Like, this is me crying. Like, my voice is a little crackled, but, like, shit like this happen all the time where it's just, like, fuck it. I don't know if that's good or bad. And, like, that's... And, like, people be thinking I be doing this for clout. For, like... No. at the end of the day, this is how I look at my life. You know what I'm trying to say? My life is beautiful. You feel me? I'm happy in my skin. You know, I'm fulfilled. I have this drive because deep down inside, like, I'm angry. You know what I'm trying to say? So many people hurt me. So many people say I'm not going to do it. You know what I mean? So it's just like, I got no choice but to keep going, you know? So it's just like, there you go. There goes some emotion. Like, I got no choice but to keep going. But it's like, some days I'm living in hell in my mind. Like, literally. So it's like, if I'm living in hell and I'm going to live in hell to get to my goals, then it's like, I'm going to share the journey with you guys. And like, you know, I don't feel like, you know, hopefully God got another plan, but I don't feel as though I was destined for relationships. I would always have to look over my back because I'd be like, I'm little as fuck. Like, I'd be afraid somebody just gonna snatch me up. I'm mad little. But no, like I was saying, like, it's just like, if I'm gonna do this, and in order to get to my goals, and it's not even about me, it's like, I'm gonna be stuck like this, you guys. Like, if I don't do nothing for myself, then I'm gonna be stuck like this. And it's like, I try every day, and it's difficult. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, I went to go get my permit today, and I didn't get to achieve it because I didn't have $80, you know, at the time to really get my permit. So I'm like, I'm about to pay my rent before I put $80 on this goddamn permit. So it's just like shit like that. But I'm tired. Like, I don't want to keep going. Not like life-wise. I just don't want to keep walking. Like, my feet hurt. It's dark as fuck.
Working right now. But you did also say you've got the full ride to college. Mm-hmm. And you said, you didn't say, I'm going to have to try to find a job. You said, I'm going to get a job.
Mm-hmm.
Another job.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know that you can't.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get through school and you have an entire world mm-hmm. around you opened up to you.
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask, what are you going to school for?
I'm going to school to be an epidemiologist. I'm in the process, like, right now, like, of getting my life insurance. I have a job opportunity, like, well, because I, okay, like, basically, like, there was this opportunity with, like, this life insurance company, and they're like, hey, do you want an opportunity? Right now, I'm in the process of doing my exam, which is on the 29th, but it's just, like, scary, too, because it's, like, I, like, have so much that, like, oh, I'm gonna do this, and, like, I'm just afraid that I'm gonna, like, fail the test, and then, you know, and I already built, like, myself, like, I kind of messed up in some aspect in life a little bit, because, like, I recorded, like, ever since, like, I was 12, I was kind of, like, with, like, my parents and stuff, like, I use social media as a way to escape my reality of my life. So it kind of, like, forcefully in some aspects, because I told so much to the universe and to the world, it's like, no matter if I try to go low-key, I still have people that are, like, I still have that pressure of being, like, you know what I mean? Of being an inspiration, because of so many people see, like, oh, you know what I mean? Like, I remember when, you know, I'm trying to say when, you know, you were living in, like, downstairs from a trap house, and, like, you know, all that stuff, and now you're in Mill Creek, and, like, in a nice area by yourself, but it's so much that comes to that, you know what I'm trying to say? And it's, like, you know, so I just always have that pressure as well of, like, you know, it's no way, so I just embrace it, you know what I'm trying to say? And just, like, okay, like, I guess since, like, I started it, I'm just, like, put my life out there because, like, I guess I'm helping other people, but at the end of the day, I'm also broken as well, you know what I'm trying to say? It's just, like, so weird because, like, even if I was, like, okay, whatever, I told so much to, like, the universe, like, people are still watching, do you know what I mean?
it's like a weird feeling. So it's just like I do YouTube videos or whatever, but to answer your question, like, I'm in the process of doing my my life insurance on the 23rd, and like I'm just like nervous about that. And then like with my job, yes, I have college and yes, I have a full ride, but to maintain college and school and work, I have to work 12-hour shifts. I can only work Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So that means that that's 38 hours. Yes, I get paid more money, but that's only 3 days of work. The check is only like... What you see? She thinks she know me because she stopped my IG. The
devil keep on calling me. Alright, what is up, you guys? So I am super tired. It is 5:30, you guys. 5:30, November 14, 2021. I say that because I'm always like doing my videos like, you know, backwards as fuck. So today is interesting. I've been cleaning my house. I've been up all night, all day. Basically, they're like, if you don't have $700-some in 4 days, you gotta leave. I came up with that money, working, doing what I gotta do. And now my job is like, we don't have a job position for you because it was too far. We were scared that you weren't going to be reliable. So now, all this shit that I'm doing, you guys, I also have to take a CNA course. Mind you, the semester, you see how God works, you guys? Do you guys see how God, the devil works? He sees that you're doing good. He sees that you're on the right track. Boom, there's something that happens. I lost my job. You feel me? So now I got to go find a new job. So now, luckily, I have a good savings and I have to put $3,000, you know, to my landlord just to so then I can look for a job. So I have basically 1 month to go find a job. So I gotta do the CNA program. I'm just stressing because the semester I got in passing was a 78. But 78 in college can go down really fast. So it's like you really gotta be on your shit. Like you don't wanna get a bad grade or anything. So I have to balance like doing well in college. I got a presentation due. My report was due yesterday, but I was walking and shit, so I couldn't turn it in. So I gotta find a good excuse for that. So I'm just pulling an all-nighter, you guys. I look like shit. I don't care. This is the real becoming Nolani Lasanta. I'm not quitting. I'm not fucking quitting. You feel me? Because I'm going through all this shit and I'm not quitting. I got my life insurance course. I'm going to be studying that at the same time. It's just, you know, because I don't want to give up on that either, because once I say something or I'm like, this is what I'm doing, people follow. You know, I'm going to be damned. I'm going to be damned if somebody's going to get in the position that I mapped out. Fuck you talking about. So it's like, you gotta do it, you know. So I got college CNA program and I'm gonna fucking study for life insurance. Those are three different type of things. Those are not even the same. Public health, fucking life insurance, that's business. And then you got CNA, completely different things. Like, we're gonna do it, you guys. We got this. I gotta finish cleaning, you guys. I just wanna keep you guys updated.
Basically means if something is getting 7%, which is the stock market, over its life, it's about 7%.
Right.
Okay? That over, every 10 years, whatever that is, it doubles. Okay? So let's say you had, just for the hell of it, $1,000, right? And you're 20 years old. And you put it in the stock market, and you left it alone. And specifically in a Roth IRA. Okay? So when you're 30, it's worth $2,000. When you're 40, it's worth $4,000. When you're 50, it's worth $8,000. When you're 60, it's worth $16,000. And when you're 70, it's $32,000. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, that is. What is up, you guys? Hold on. What? What?
what is up? So yeah, so basically, like, I told you guys, like, I'm going to be really honest. Like, I'm not gonna hide shit from you guys. Like, if I'm gonna do YouTube, I'm gonna do it right, and that's what I'm gonna do. Like, you know, I'm trying to say, I'm not gonna hide you guys so you guys don't see this vulnerable side, but in some aspects, this vulnerable side is me. So it's like, I want to give you guys all aspects of me, and I don't want to hide the parts of me, even though it's hard, because, like, for those that have been watching me for, you know, the videos that I have posted, thank you so much. And now we finally got to this day, and I really didn't want to record because I'm like, I am not in a mood, but it is the day that my name change is finally complete. And I'm just going to tell you guys how, like, you know, sum it up, how school been going. So school, I did pass one of my classes, and my other two classes, I was doing really, really well. In my microeconomics, and then I didn't have $400 in a week, so it just caused my classes to just crumble after that. And then I had so much stuff with my name change that wasn't going right. My business, I did start my business, and it was going really good, but I realized that I can't do a business and go to school at the same time, because I just can't. So I still have it. I still do it because I'm really talented with doing eyelashes and facials and stuff like that. I just, whoever asks me, then I'll do it, but I don't promote it or anything. And then just, you know, of like my car situation, I mean, my bills are crazy. Like, I lost my financial aid, so therefore it's coming all out of pocket. So I have to pay $600 a month just to stay in school, plus my rent is $1,000 plus other bills. So it's just like, it's a lot on my plate because I didn't have a co-signer to sign my stuff. So it's just like, I will catch myself where everybody is like, everybody that knows me is like, you're always talking about the past. You're always want somebody to feel sympathy for you. That is not it. You guys, this is the whole point of my name change, is to like step into a new, you know, I'm trying to say a new energy, you know, because as you guys see, like, my energy is really low, and I've been like this for a really, really long time. And like, you know, if you really want to get real, I have like two friends, you know what I'm trying to say? Besides that, you know, I'm not trying to talk about my life, but, you know, I'm trying to say, like, everybody else is like fake ass relationships in every ass aspect. Like, you know what I'm trying to say? If you knew my situation, you know what I'm trying to say? If you knew my situation, I basically didn't have a good upbringing, got in placement at 14, and then when I basically was locked up from 14 to 17, got out of 17, was forced to be an adult, and just been struggling ever since. So like, after 20 years of just grinding, and like, my parents, like, my mother is in poverty, you know what I'm trying to say? My grandma was in poverty, my whole family's in poverty. So it's therefore of like, always have to outthink your life and always move five steps ahead, which is like, it gets tiring after a while, it really does. So like, you know, I'm not trying to be on no suicide shit, but like, you know, I'm very, very tired, and you can see and you can tell in my tone that like, I had enough, you know, but I have to hang in there for whatever reason, you know. But today is the name change, and yeah, today's the name change, and just subscribe to my YouTube video. It's the life of Nolani. I don't know. Remember, I was in the first video when I first started, I was like, it's the life of Amaya. But my name is no longer Amaya. That's crazy as fuck too, because y'all saw me. Like, literally, you guys got to just wake up and be like, that bitch is just changing her name. Because when I first started this YouTube channel and just starting, I didn't have the impression. I just was like really depressed and was like, I need to save my soul before it dies, all dies, and there's just no left of no spark. The funniness of me is gonna be gone. I gotta save myself. Save me. What's that Mick Mill song? Save me. Whatever. But yeah, so like, subscribe to my channel, you guys. There's gonna be more videos uploaded. I can't really tell you on the top of my mind, but I know my life is busy, so I'm always doing some shit. Some shit's always changing, so it's gonna be interesting. Yes, you guys. I don't know how my thing is gonna be. Comment below what you think my what's that saying called? What you think my theme should be? Should it be, it's the life of Nolani?
or what's up you guys, it's Nolani. I don't know, I think about it in my sleep. But not like, what was I saying? No, I'm really good though. Like, I feel as though like I was meant to be like a public figure, but I'm super good at like healing people. Like, that's the thing about me. Like, I feel as though like I'm not good, honestly, in a personal standards, I'm not good with people. But like in my personal life, I don't do good with no relationships. I don't know why. I really don't know why I don't do good with relationships. Like, friendships, kind of, but even that be like on shaky eggshells. And I think it's just probably in my past. But when it comes to healing people, I can see through all people. Like, I can feel people's pains. It's crazy. And like, people like, and that's what I'm saying, I think that's what's keeping me alive right now, honestly, is the fact that like, ooh, that's so powerful. Like, okay, I might be alone in person, right? But the thing is, online, it's another world. So it's like, I got all this love and this attention online. Like, my spirit being on earth is like, my spirit being on earth is so powerful because I uplift people. You know what I'm trying to say? I could think of 10 people on my hands that like, just me being in the present and me having the positive mindset that I do, I made them a better person. And that's not on no bragging shit. That's on truthful honesty. Like, I could think of 10 people on right now where I just like made them a better person just with my spirit being around them. And I feel like a lot of people pretend like they don't see me, but you fucking see me. You see me. Not on YouTube. I love y'all. I'm talking about in real life, in personal life, in my city. Like, y'all fucking see me. Y'all act like y'all don't fucking see me. Y'all see me. And, you know, it's crazy. Motherfuckers act like they don't see you, but you're inspired. You know, my energy is powerful, and I know that within myself. So it's like, that's why I can't, like, take the easy route out, even though it's hard, and, like, kill myself, to be honest. Like, I want to. That's probably why I'm going to sleep and shit. But, like, but I can't. I can't, because I know my presence here on earth is powerful. So, like, that's selfish, though. That's selfish. So, I know if I was to probably do that, I probably would break, like, 30 people's, like, room 30 people's hearts without even knowing. Because people did me fucked up. And, like, part of me wants to be like, I want you to live with that shit. Like, I gotta live with this shit every fucking day. But then there's a part of me that got the nice, the sweet side. That's like, nah, bro. Don't wish bad on other people because they did you bad. So, it's just like, I just gotta boss the fuck up.
Want to know something unique I'm doing too? I've been recording my experience for a whole year.
Oh yeah?
On YouTube, because I did YouTube, but then I deleted it. So I have like a camera that's like $3,000, and I just have like footage. So then when like at this part right here, with me changing my name, then I'm going to start uploading it slowly. Yeah. So like every week, I'm going to just upload it, and then people are going to be 6 months behind. Because like, I don't like people, like Erie's very small, you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, hell yeah, dude.
So I don't want like, if it's a small city, I don't want everybody knowing my every move like that. You know what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. So if people are 6 months behind, then they won't know my current move.
Right.
Smart, right?
Very smart.
So I'm like, this video, like, is going to be of, like, me. Like, and then what's crazy, too, when I was doing my video, like, I didn't just, like, plan on this. Like, oh, I'm going to make a YouTube because I'm going to be in Nolani. I literally just woke up one day, was, like, in one of the videos, was just like, I'm just sad. I'm always crying all the time. I'm going to change my name. That's what it is. Like, it's my name change.
But no, like, seriously. I feel like that was really just the hardest part, was just accepting, you know. But I really, really, really do feel like this did help, honestly. And I know people are just going to be like, it's a name change. But it's like, now it's like a start all over. Like, literally a start. It's like fresh. I'm like starting all over. And it really feels good. I'm just kind of sad for the people that like kind of left me in the process. Because like, I was really trying my best. And like, I don't think people understood how like depressed I was or how sad I was. And I just feel like people gave up on me and they left me. So it's cool though. Cause, I have wonderful friends, friend. I have a wonderful friend. She's really supportive.
So yeah, you guys, so I'm going to make a note of this video. I'm gonna say, what should this video be called? Losing weight, grinding hard. I'm gonna just do that. I mean, put that in my folder. Yeah, I can't play regular music because I'm gonna get copyright, so. Let me check on my appointment with the life insurance to make sure that they're following through, because I don't wanna waste my time and I don't wanna waste nobody else's time, so. You ever feel as though, like, I don't know, like, I feel as though, like, it's at the point where it's, like, I'm guided by a spirit. Like, no, not trying to be all, like, weird, but you ever believe in, like, ancestors and shit? Like, maybe, like, I don't know. Sometimes I just think my purpose here is, like, literally in my brain, it's, like, your purpose here, because I got 100 years. 100 years and I'm dead. Period. That's human biology. That's what the fuck happens. Like, maybe I was here and brought here just to break the generation curse. That's what I feel as though. I don't give a fuck. Like, all this shit that I've been through, that's it. Because I'm only gonna have 100 years in this bitch. That's it. And I'm dying. Like, I don't think people think like down the average day. I think everybody thinks we're immortal. Bitch, you only got like 20, 30, you got 100 years tops. That's it. And that's why every day I grind for a bigger purpose, because I'm not going to be here every day. But yes, like I was telling you guys, like, I don't know. I can't explain it. Like, I was in that energy just 2 weeks ago of just, like, feeling this emptiness. And just 4 months ago after that, I was very suicidal. And now it's like I'm in this energy where it's like I'm finally, like, lifted. My spirit's lifted. Ever since I changed my name, it's like, you feel me? I knew it was gonna happen, bro. I told you, I don't know what the fuck. See, that's why I follow my heart. That's why I follow with the fuck. Whatever I do, I just do. I don't give a fuck what people's opinion is, because imagine if I ain't changed my name because I was afraid of what the fuck everybody else got to say. I would have been suffering internally. And what I realized, when you're suffering internally, nobody really knows that you're suffering or feel your pain. Like, they can relate to your pain, but can you feel my pain? You can't fathom somebody's pain. You can think that you understand them, but you can't feel their pain. So therefore, like, I realized, like, I gotta pick myself up for I die, like, mentally die. And I was like, nah, I can't see myself go like that, because I didn't been through too much shit to just watch myself in a flash of my eye just go like that, you know. But I gotta get ready for work. I was just ranting, you guys. And the reason why I say you're the main character, right? This is why. You're the main character because you can control you. I can do this. I can wave my hand. I bet you those that are watching that can do the same. I can't do that for you. So therefore, I have control of my life. So if you think about your brain in the aspect of, like, your brain is the creator of the book. Feel me? It's the editor. So, like, for instance, in some aspects, I'm manifesting the life that I want. And I've been manifesting since I was a young girl, of like, oh, I don't want to be in the hood. You know, I don't want to be in that type of neighborhood. I want to get out of that type of neighborhood. Look where I'm at, you know. And give it, when I was 10 years old, I was living downstairs from a trap house, across the street from a trap house. And all I can imagine is me being in a nice neighborhood. Yeah, it's hard, but that's what I wanted to do. Next is a car. Like, I need a fucking car, but I'm gonna get there. You know what I'm trying to say? Shit don't happen overnight. And it's just like, I really love the nighttime, like walking in the night, because I really like collect my thoughts. So I'm not gonna hold you guys, because I don't have a car. I was walking at night, an hour or two in from work, but I found this girl that gives me a ride, and she's so helpful, so I don't have to walk to and from anymore. guys, like, I really want to record this process because, like, a lot of people go through this, and I don't show this and I don't explain it often, but, like, I want to talk about in this episode or this vlog, like, my manic bipolar and, like, what it is. Like, obviously, you guys see, like, that, like, sorry, I really can't think right now. Basically, what triggered it is, like, okay, so what manic bipolar is, like, basically where you have episodes of, like, you have this high energy, like, your body is, like, naturally high, like, you feel as though you can do anything in the whole wide world, and you can't control it, you can't control when you're gonna feel that way, you just wake up and you just gotta go with it. When you are basically down, you're 10 times depressed than the average person. So when I was younger, I didn't know why I would just, like, not sleep, or I would not go to school for a week, and I would not go to work. As an adult, I can't do that, especially, like, depending on myself. Like, I have no support but myself, so it's like I can't fuck up, and that's a lot of pressure on me. So, a lot of people that have manic bipolar doesn't want to admit that they have manic bipolar. They're like, there's nothing wrong with me, woo woo woo. And they are not aware. Me, I'm aware. So this caused me to be like a workaholic, because, like, I can't control when I'm feeling this hyper. I can't control when I'm feeling really low. So I have to, it's 10 times harder for me to do what I'm doing, because I have to, like, do healthy things, like, within myself, on top of being busy. Like, right now, like, I have to, like, took a shower, like, you know, I'm in a robe, and it helps me relax. And coffee, for some reason, like, helps me relax. Like, when I drink it, it just puts me in a calm state, and that's how you know, like, I'm probably, like, you know what I mean, like, I don't, my brain is, like, very hyper, because coffee makes people normal. But to me, hold on, let me get some lotion. Yeah, but for me it's not like that, you know what I mean? Like, I know, and I'm aware of, like, my bipolar. So my manic bipolar, bipolar one is different. Like, this one is, like, more like you have mood swings, and manic bipolar is like these episodes. Like, Kanye West has bipolar, and, like, manic bipolar, he's a genius. Like, literally, he's a genius. And I feel as though I'm the same way. Because of bipolar, you think, like, 10 times ahead of everything, and you do a lot of things, and I have the energy to do it. It's just I have to make sure that I do that every day. And, like, most bipolar people, they would start a project and not finish. Me, I like to finish, because I know I'm aware of bipolar, and I don't want to be a statistic. So I always have that anxiety in my mind, like, you know, you got to, you know, do what you finished. And the fact that, like, I'm literally mentally fighting myself, because, you know, last year was really hard in college too, because, like, there's some days that you're just overwhelmed. Like, if you have any mental anything in college, it's 10 times harder, it's 10 times enhanced, because you're the rhythm. And not only do I have, like, stuff that's going on with, like, my presentation and all this other stuff, I also have things that are, like, I was gonna be, like, 5 days and I was gonna be on the street, you know. Not only that, my job fired me, basically. Not my life insurance is going good, but because of my busy schedule, I haven't got licensed yet, and I have to study, but I also have a presentation and a paper due, and it's just so much thrown at me at once that I'm, like, you know, like, my manic is triggered. So I'm, like, very hyper, like, so and I can't control it. Like, if you could feel in my body, it feels as though, like, you're on crack. Like, literally, you're on crack, you're on drugs. And I'm not on any drugs at all. I'm completely 100% sober. So I just have to, like, calm my body down, because, like, I don't know, I would just be all over the place. I wouldn't be focused. That's why I'm very, very organized. I have, like, sticky notes
Come to your library to help you to become better at your craft.
It's what goes on between this year and this year, and in our hearts, that determine our lives out there. There's no world out there except what's going on here.
I think it's important that you really like whatever you're doing. If you don't like it, life is too short.
If I'm lying to you about who I am, or I'm lying to you about whatever, there's no starting point. There's a false reality. You have to create the real reality.
It's a good separation for me, you know, emotionally, to be able to put myself in a place where at practice or when I'm training or during games, I switch my mind to something else.
I I became number one in the world. I became a millionaire not because I made more money. I became a millionaire because they told me millionaires only live off of 30% of their income. I became a millionaire because I did what millionaires did. I stopped living off 100%.
What does it mean? Time is money, right? How do you multiply time? How do you buy time? Rich people buy time.
Most of the people watching this thing should either not...